means and the new medical systems just to survive the total form of true enslavement. And then they're there posing as the saviors when they've created the problem. Somebody's got to do something about it, and then they're there to give the solution.
Problem, reaction, solution. This was in the British press this week, Alex. Headline, forget the internet, soon there will be the outer net. Company plans to beam free Wi-Fi to every person on Earth from space. It was in the London Daily Mail. They're quoting an organization called Media Development Investment Fund in the United States, which is among its funders are the Open Society Foundations of George Soros. You know that man that has...
Oh, he likes us.
And what they're saying is they want to beam it from space because they care about freedom of expression, you see. So they want to get over the restrictions in China and all this. They're such nice people. And give us internet...
They want to beam it into Russia, overthrow that, exactly.
Yeah. Now, what this is, I would suggest, and there'll be other things too, is another layer on, because the when I talk about the internet, what I'm also talking about is the lower levels of the Earth's atmosphere where we interact and live our lives. They want to fill that with so much electromagnetic information broadcasting within the human brainwave and genetic frequency, that we are bombarded with basically a...
Frequency pollution, a jamming signal.
24/7 programming system. This is what smart meters are about. What are they doing? They're creating a Wi-Fi radiation field, yet another one. That's very kind, very sensible, thank you. Within every home and business, that's the idea with the smart grids. And you know, people have said, and rightly too, that what they're doing is being able to see when you open your fridge, how many people's in your house, what room they're in, what
exactly.
You're doing. Yes. But, you know, as they say on a motorbike, the throttle goes both ways. Well, so does the Wi-Fi. You can get information from a location, and you can pick up that location.
No, that's on record. Let me expand on this. When I go to Big Bend, where I'd love to go live, but it's the middle of nowhere, you know, down in South West Texas on the Mexican border, and there's nothing on that side of Mexico either. Your cell phones don't work. Literally, even though I'm at 9,000 feet or whatever, I feel 20 years younger. It's like heaven because there's no Wi-Fi. But now it's not going to matter. They're launching blimps and satellites that are going to blast everything. And there's all these people moving to the countrysides in Europe and worldwide, as you know, to get away from frequency pollution. Sorry, you're not going to get away from it. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, this is what I'll point, I'll come to in a second, about trying to run away. You're not trying to run away. We've got to run straight at these people. Because if you're trying to run away, you'll run away for a while, and then it'll catch you up. I mean, we've got to deal with it, for goodness sake. Don't run away from it. And so what is happening is that with the smart meters, that's another electromagnetic field, which is not only taking information from your home and business and delivering that to a central point, information's coming the other way within the frequency of human brainwave activity. So it can feed you impressions, it can feed you perceptions, it can feed you thoughts and beliefs. That's the idea. And what Hollywood is doing, I mean, what are we talking about? A perception deception, Hollywood, my goodness. It's one of the great vehicles for it. You know, I've been 50-odd countries everywhere you go.
That's where I wanted to go next, though. I want to stop you right there because I only got like 15 minutes or 5 minutes of the next hour with you, Max. DavidIke.com joining us right now. Again, I'm Alex Jones. If you just tuned in, David, you know a lot of famous people. I know a lot of famous people. Most of them do not have the courage to go public. I mean, most big Hollywood stars, A-list, most big producers I know, 95% of them won't come on air. But a lot of them have come on air. And in Hollywood, it's not liberal or conservative. They're listening to you. They're listening to me. They're all awake. They hate the old shadowy producers, Sumner Redstone and others that won't let them tell the truth. There's a revolution going on in Hollywood. And I see it in the new Lego movie, in the new Nut Job movie, anti-establishment, how they want to program us. And that's not propaganda. There's a war going on, even in Hollywood. I mean, take Alice Walker of The Color Purple and all her big tops, who's a listener of you, a listener of me. She promotes us, gets attacked. My point is that we're going to skip this network break, folks. We're going to skip another break. This is so important. David Icke, I'm saying we are on the edge of winning because this isn't fake. Almost everyone in Hollywood, I've now learned, is a listener of this show, and they talk about you as well. And I'm not on a power trip over that. This is the main enemy brainwashing base, and we, by the grace of the Creator and human consciousness and everything, and our listeners, we've not infiltrated them. They are in the programming system. They know the truth better than us. They're absolutely freaking out. The military's waking up because they're decompartmentalized with our information. This is incredible. So what do you want to say about that? Because I want to be clear. Hollywood is on the verge of a huge awakening and a revolution against the old guys that control it. David Icke.
Well, just take Hollywood, take any aspect of this global spider's web, and Hollywood will fit the blueprint. You've got a very few people that call the shots, and you've got everyone else that dance to the shots that are called. What has happened, thanks to the internet up to this point and books and many other, you know, vehicles, is that, yes, the compartmentalized structure is being decompartmentalized. Because before, there was no way that those in the compartmentalized structure could get access to information that only those they knew. So they were always in the dark. They were always a piece in a puzzle they didn't understand. They didn't realize there was a puzzle. They just knew that little piece and they thought that was it. What has happened, because this information has circulated and circulated and circulated, and my goodness me, the number of people that are interested in it now is phenomenal compared with just a few years ago even. Those compartments are breaking down because people lower down in the structure are going, hold on a second, when they hear this information, that makes sense of what I'm doing every day. That makes sense of why I was asked to do this movie and do this scene and read this script. But what I would say, Alex, you know, is yes, people are waking up, but you know, we can't just hold it at a point where we're waking up while still standing on the other side of the street, knowing more about what's happening and watching it with more understanding of the unfolding.
Yeah, it's kind of like being conscious while you're being roasted. It's almost worse if you don't reverse it.
We've got to cross the street and engage this, right? And there has to be a revolution of the many to refuse to acquiesce to the impositions of the few. And because, I mean, those people, I'll say to those people in Hollywood that are well off and have lots and lots of money, but are not part of this whole thing, they may be caught in it, but they're not part of it. I would say this to people in America and around the world who at the moment think that they're okay and they're well off or comfortable and it don't really affect them. Well, hold on. There are people now in tent cities in America and homeless in the streets in places like Britain who not long ago considered themselves to be middle class and had a nice house and a big mortgage at which they could at that time pay. It turns very quickly because the where we're heading is what I call the Hunger Games Society. And it's real simple. And my goodness me, can you not see it now? It's for less than 1%. To control all wealth, land, water, food production, all of it, to have then a strata of uniformed programs, software programs called the police state, with no ability to process information, just to respond to orders. Psychopaths, sociopaths, narcissists, we're seeing them being recruited on a personality basis rather than an ability basis all the time. And under that is planned to be everyone else in a slave masses with a major, massive culling as well, which are subordinate. And those slaves will be subject to microchips and other forms of
forced inoculations. It's already happening. 200 square foot coffin apartments.
This is the point, Alex. When you realize and you know what's happening and you know where it's going, you read the world like an open book. This stuff now, you see these things where you swallow pills and have an edible microchip.
We told people that was coming.
which then tell your mobile phone or your doctor's mobile phone when your next dose is due and if you've had it or not. That's all part of this process of forced drugging that this slave...
And they start it when you get allergy medicine over the counter now, swiping your card and telling you the state police are watching you. That's what the smart dust is about, the RFID, in their own words, a total enslavement grid. How do you think the fight against the spiders is going? How is the fight against the technocrats going?
Well, what I would say to everybody in Hollywood or elsewhere, we now have reached the point that pussyfooting around and doing a little bit and keeping your head down, I've watched the Alex Jones show, I read that David Icke's books, but I can't say anything because what about my career? Those days, ladies and gentlemen, are over if you have any desire to live in a world that even has a modicum of freedom. There's no more time for messing around and having it an add-on to your life. This is a time to stand up and be counted, to come out the big Hollywood names that are hiding in the shadows at the moment because they fear the consequences. I tell you what, the consequences of not dealing with this now are going to be far, far worse than...
Exactly.
Or not doing it, the consequences...
Well, David, people tell me all the time, they go, thank you for your courage. I would have to have blind, crazy courage to not fight this. I'm fighting it because I know how horrible it is where they're taking us. Just like you said, wait, I'm not doing this because I have courage. I'm doing this because I want to survive and have consciousness and freedom and free will for myself and humanity. I hate bondage. I hate these psychopaths that, you know, the whole royal group that you expose, it's all come out and the dead bodies and the little kids and the BBC pedophile rings. I mean, my God, it isn't courage fighting these people. My very instinct says we need to absolutely rout them.
Yeah, the thing is, let's look at it. There was a point some time ago where this control grid was not what it is. The manipulation of perception was not as ingrained as it is becoming among large numbers of people who are not waking up. So as this moves on, more and more people who are not waking up become more and more programmed, more and more incapable of free thought and ever seeing what it is. So we can't wait until, because what happens, and I've talked about this before, is they push the gate. In other words, they'll push the agenda on. And if they don't meet resistance, then they'll walk through the gate to the next gate. And then this is how it moves on. So we have to, when are we going to draw a line in the sand? When are people, just use this analogy for now, but an analogy for humanity. When are the people in Hollywood that understand some of what's going on, and indeed some of them a lot of what's going on, how long are you going to stay silent? What, until there's a knock on the door? I mean, there won't be anyone around then. Come on, we have to get on with it now. And never, never in my 25 years nearly of doing this, never have there been more open minds to seeing this. People are opening their minds now to things they would have laughed and dismissed by reflex action before. This is a fantastic opportunity we're facing now. There was always a time when this was going to break the surface.
And we're here, we're alive now. David, do 5 more minutes with us. I know you got to go. I want you to tell us about your book and the TV network when we come back. Back in 60. Short break, folks. Stay with us. This is Dr. Group in studio. Stay with us. It's my 40th birthday spending it with David Icke. This is fun.
My friends, Alex Jones here to tell you about some of the most important information concerning you and your family's health. Radiation levels have more than doubled in the last 60 years in the Northern Hemisphere from all of the nuclear testing and radiological accidents. Radioactive contamination is now in most of the food supply. There's only 2 ways to avoid this. Move south of the equator or properly protect your thyroid with Nascent Iodine. Looking to protect my family, I've done deep research. Nascent Iodine is the purest, cleanest, absolute best form of of iodine to protect yourself and your family. It's made right here in the USA, completely non-GMO. I searched out the best quality and now have developed a double-strength form of nascent iodine, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Nascent iodine is on record as one of the only safe ways to detox from fluoride poisoning. Survival Shield Nascent Iodine. Secure your super high-quality nascent iodine today at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com.